In this video, we're going to start the KUTA Software Infinite Geometry Free Worksheet Multi-Step Special Right Triangles. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Our directions are to find the missing side lengths. Leave your answer as radicals in simplest form. Now in this video, I'm going to do numbers 1 through 6, and that deals with 45, 45, 90 triangles. And if you remember the ratios, that's 1 to 1 to the square root of 2. My ratio I'll set as y to y to the square root of 2y. Since the ratio is 1 to 1 to the square root of 2, or y to y to the square root of 2, the legs of a 45, 45, 90 degree triangle are congruent. So looking at this triangle with a hypotenuse of 10, this side length is going to be congruent to this side length. And looking at this second right triangle, where one of the sides is x, that side x is going to be congruent to this side. So in order to solve for x, we're going to solve for the hypotenuse of the triangle where x is a side, and then use that hypotenuse to solve for x. So setting up our ratios, we'll have y to y to the square root of 2 times y. And remember, this is the square root of 2 times y, where the y is outside of the radical. So the square root of 2 times y is equal to 10. So we'll solve for y by dividing by the square root of 2. So y is going to equal 10 divided by the square root of 2. So we'll do 10 over the square root of 2 times 1, so that'll be the square root of 2 over the square root of 2. That'll give us the y is equal to 10 square root of 2 over 2, which will simplify since 10 is divided by 2 to give us 5 times the square root of 2. Since we don't want a radical in our denominator, we multiply by 1 and then simplify. So if y is equal to 5 square root of 2, we have 5 square root of 2, and for this we also have 5 square root of 2. So now we're going to set up another ratio. X is one of the side lengths, so this other side length is also x. So our ratio will be x to the square root of 2 times x. So if 5 times the square root of 2 is equal to the square root of 2 times x, since this is 1 to 1 to the square root of 2, and putting x in, that'll be x to the square root of 2x. All we need to do is divide by the square root of 2 to solve for x. The square root of 2 will cancel out on both sides of my equation, and I'll get that 5 is equal to x. So 5 is my missing side length in number 1. And number 2, let's find our congruent sides. In the bottom right triangle, this side is congruent to this side. So since 7 is one leg, 7 is also the other leg. And in my other right triangle, this leg is congruent to this leg. So we're solving for the hypotenuse. But in order to do that, we need to find the hypotenuse of this side and then solve for x. So if we have 7 and 7 as the side lengths, let's just say that 7 is equal to y. So this side length will be the square root of 2 times y, which will be 7 square root of 2. And if this side is 7 square root of 2, then this side is also 7 square root of 2, since the legs are congruent. Now we just need to solve for that hypotenuse. Now we can look at our ratios. So x is going to be equal to the square root of 2 times our side length, 7 times the square root of 2. So that'll be 7 times the square root of 2 times the square root of 2, which we can write as 7 times 2, which will give us 14. So our missing side length x is 14. And that's because the legs were 7 square root of 2, so 1 to 1 to the square root of 2, we could think of as z to the square root of 2 times z, where this is the square root of 2 times z. And number 3, this leg of this top triangle is congruent to this leg of 9, so this is also 9. And this hypotenuse is a leg of another right triangle, so that leg is congruent to this leg. So if my legs are 9 and 9 of this first triangle, my hypotenuse is going to be 9 times the square root of 2. 1 to 1 to the square root of 2. And if this is 9 times the square root of 2, then this leg is also 9 times the square root of 2. And now we have 1 to 1 to the square root of 2. So if 9 square root of 2 is equivalent to y, x will be equivalent to the square root of 2 times y. So x equals the square root of 2 times y, and we know that y is 9 times the square root of 2. So rearranging, we'll just write 9 times the square root of 2 times the square root of 2. So that will be 9 times 2. So x is going to be equal to 18. So x is 18 in number 3. And number 4, x is a leg of a triangle. So that leg is congruent to this other leg. And the hypotenuse of that triangle is a leg of another right triangle. So those two legs are congruent. So let's say this leg is y, and that leg's y. So the hypotenuse dealing with x is y. So we have 1 to 1 to the square root of 2. So that's y to the square root of 2y. So for the ratio in the top triangle, the square root of 2 times y equals 9. So if we divide by the square root of 2, we'll get that y is equal to 9 over the square root of 2, which we'll multiply by 1 in order to get that radical out of the denominator. So that'll be 9 square root of 2 over 2. And that is y. And y, in this case, is equal to the square root of 2 times x, since x to the square root of 2x is our ratio in the other triangle. So if y is also equal to the square root of 2 times x, so y is equal to 9 square root of 2 over 2. And that's equal to the square root of 2 times x. So what we'll do is divide by the square root of 2. And when we divide by the square root of 2, that's the same as multiplying by 1 over the square root of 2. So 9 times the square root of 2 over 2 times 1 over the square root of 2 is equal to x. So all I have to do is multiply, and you can see that my radicals will cancel out. So I'll get 9 halves is equal to x. So 9 halves is my answer in number 4. And number 5, I know that this leg is congruent to this leg, and this leg is congruent to this leg. So we're solving for one of the legs, x. First, let's solve for these legs. Let's do y to the square root of 2 times y. So in order to solve for y, I'll divide by the square root of 2. So 5 is equal to y. And if y is 5, I'll set up my other ratio. That'll be x to the square root of 2x. So y is equal to the square root of 2 times x, and if y is 5, I'll plug 5 in, and that's equal to the square root of 2 times x, and now I can solve for x by dividing by the square root of 2. So 5 over the square root of 2 is equal to x. However, I do not want a radical in my denominator, so I'll multiply that by 1, which is square root of 2 over square root of 2. So for my final solution, in number 5, I'll get 5 times the square root of 2 over 2 is equal to x. And that's my answer in number 5. And lastly in this video, number 6. Again, this side is congruent to this side since they're the legs of a 45-45-90 triangle. And this leg x is congruent to this leg because they're also legs of a 45-45-90 triangle. Now setting up my ratio, I'll have y as my legs of this first triangle, and that's going to be equal to the square root, and the hypotenuse will be square root of 2 times y. So if 9 square root of 6 equals square root of 2 times y, dividing by the square root of 2, I'll get that 9 times the square root of 3 is equal to y. So if y is 9 times the square root of 3, I can also see that y is equal to the square root of 2 times x, since y is the hypotenuse of another 45-45-90. So plugging y in, which is 9 times the square root of 3, I'll get that is equal to the square root of 2 times x. So dividing by the square root of 2, I'll get that 9 square root of 3 over square root of 2 is equal to x. However, I don't want a radical in my denominator, so I'm going to multiply by 1. That'll give me that x is equal to 9 times the square root of 6, since the square root of 2 times the square root of 3 is the square root of 6, all over the square root of 2 times the square root of 2, which is 2. So 9 times the square root of 6 over 2 is my solution in number 6. So essentially, in numbers 1 through 6, we set up our ratio of sides, solve for either the side or the hypotenuse, and then use that answer to get X. If you found this helpful, click that subscribe button, and while you're at it, go ahead and give me a thumbs up. Continue on to the next video, where I'll do the next 5 problems, completing numbers 7 through 11. Feel free to leave a comment below, like, subscribe, and share.